this is the Private Probation Services Council meeting, and I will start with roll call. Mr. Stansel Ford?
Present.
Mr. David Nemo?
Present.
Judge Chris Kraft?
Present.
Judge John Hudson?
Present.
Thank you. We have a quorum at this point. Ms. Linda Buford is not joining us, and Judge Hugh Harvey and Judge Longback are not as well, so we will go ahead and proceed. Thank you.
All right. Would you read the statement of necessity, please?
Yes. According to TCA 844-108B2, if a physical quorum is not present at a location of a meeting of a governing body, the governing body must fill such determination of necessity. Including the recitation of the facts and circumstances on which it is based with the Office of Secretary of State no later than 2 working days after the meeting. Furthermore, TCA 8-44-108A3 defines necessity as matters to be considered by the governing body at that meeting require timely action by the body that physical presence of the quorum of the members is not practical within the period of time requiring action and that participation by the members by electronic or other means of communication is necessary. This is the regularly scheduled meeting of the Private Probation Services Council. The purpose of today's meeting, with some members attending by teleconference, is to discuss the agenda as noticed on the website earlier. Thank you.
All right, and has the notice of this meeting been properly published?
Yes, they were published on the website on January the 26th.
All right, we've all electronically received a copy of the agenda. Do I hear a motion to adopt the agenda?
So moved, Mr. Chairman. It's time for forward.
Is there a second?
Second, David Nemo.
All right, any discussion? Call the roll on the vote, please.
Thank you. Mr. Stansel Ford?
Aye.
Mr. David Nemo?
Aye.
Judge Christopher Kraft?
Aye.
Judge John Hudson?
Aye.
All in agreement. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. As far as the minutes being reviewed, I'll say one thing. I looked at the minutes, and there was one mistake in that on the first page, it says that I read the state of necessity, and I think that should be statement of necessity. But other than that, is there any other suggested corrections or amendments to the minutes? Hello?
Yeah, I'm still here.
All right.
This is John Hudson.
Thank you, Judge. Everyone else still here?
How are you?
All right. Do I hear a motion to adopt the minutes amending to show statement of necessity instead of state of necessity?
So moved, Mr. Chairman. It's time for poll.
Is there a second?
Second. John Hudson.
Any discussion? Call the roll on the vote, please.
Thank you. Mr. Stansel Ford?
Aye.
Mr. David Nemo?
Aye.
Judge Christopher Kraft?
Aye.
Judge John Hudson?
Aye.
All in agreement with the motion for the minutes as amended. Thank you.
Thank you. Legal report.
We'll turn it over to the legal counsel who is here to go over the legal case. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Pam Spicer. I'm Assistant General Counsel. I have one complaint to present to the board this morning. You all have a copy of the legal report, but for purposes of the record, I will read it. This case was received as a consumer complaint from a county employee. The complaint alleges that the respondent is providing unlicensed probation services. This was subject to an investigation. The investigative report revealed that the respondent is providing private probation services without registering with the Private Probation Council. I'm recommending that you all authorize formal hearing and authorize settlement by consent order with a $1,000 civil penalty. And I'll be happy to answer any questions anyone has.
All right. Are there any questions of her before we ask for a motion to adopt? All right. Do I hear a motion to adopt the recommendation of the council?
move, John Hudson.
Is there a second?
Second, Stansel Ford.
Any discussion? I have one question. Assuming this person is not registered, and we had a hearing, they didn't appear, or we assessed a fine and they didn't pay it, who handles that?
There's a finding that there's a violation, which there likely will be. If the person receives the penalty and tries to pay, obviously we send that out for collection. There'll be a flag if this person attempts to apply for a license in the future. I know that this respondent has a felony conviction, which would prevent him from receiving a license.
All right. Well, I guess that person knows the system inside and out then. All right. All right. Let's call a roll on the vote, please.
Yes. Stansel Ford.
Aye.
David Lee.
Aye.
Judge Christopher Crane.
Aye.
Judge John Hudson.
Aye.
All in agreement to proceed with the legal report as recommended.
All right. Director, budget report.
Thank you. We email this document as well to everyone. I will be happy to go over the actual numbers. This is the new view of the report that we are receiving from the financial department. We show through the month of November a total revenue of $42,102, total expenses $16,223, leaving us so far this fiscal year with a balance of $25,878. I think I mentioned at our last council meeting that it'll be very good to have those bottom numbers that reflect the comparison on a month-to-month with previous years so we can get a good feel. And as we discussed previously, with the reduction that we will be collecting of the fees from $1 to the 75 cents, we'll slowly see that revenue amount go down, but I think we're in good shape. Are there any questions?
Hearing none, thank you very much for your report, and I hope they stay level rather than continue to go down, so that'll be great. All right, new business. I have one question. At our last meeting, we were asking the Attorney General to give us some advice on the meaning of, because the legislature was inquiring, the meaning of someone who's considered hostile or disrespectful conduct. I didn't know if they have given you a report back on that request yet.
Good morning. This is Cheryl Huber, Assistant General Counsel. We were here with the department to review this matter and determine that we are comfortable with the rules as they are and cannot recommend any changes. There was no methodology to informally request that the Attorney General's office answer this question. And one of the most concerns is perhaps redefining these terms too specifically to the point that we're restricted from taking action in cases that may necessitate action. So we will, is recommending that we read the rules as they are at this particular time, and should a situation arise later when we discover that further specificity would be beneficial, we could review it at that point.
So I guess the question then, who is going to contact the Joint Operations Committee of the General Assembly and say that even though they'd requested a further definition, we can't provide it? I just want to make sure that our council and the legislature stay on good terms. They're basically asking us to change the rules or to further define those terms in the rules. And we're basically saying we don't want to do that. So I'm just asking if you have any wisdom about what we should do from this point on. Should we write them a letter and explain this to them, or what should we do?
Their request is for us to review it. They didn't specifically request that we take this action per se, but that we review the matter and determine whether the action needed to be taken. If the council feels that we should send a letter indicating our position on the issue, that's certainly something that we should be able to do.
Okay, because, I mean, from our minutes from last time, and the way it was put to us, the General Assembly's Operations Committee had requested further definition on some of the terms, and we talked about it, and we decided that it would be better for the Attorney General to give us an opinion on that. And if the Attorney General is recommending that we not further define those terms at this time, then I think at some point, either director or someone should communicate with the legislature and explain to them why we're not honoring their requests. So I was wondering who would be doing that. I'm not sure it's proper for someone on the council to contact the legislature.
This is Roxana. Judge, I think I understand what you're wanting and agree. We will put together a letter, and I'll make sure that the attorney for council, Ms. Hooper, review and have something to forward to them, letting them know that we've discussed it at two different meetings, that we're not adding anything else, and it'll follow the language that she recommends. That's not a problem at all. We'll take care of that.
Would you mind sending just a copy of that letter when it's done to the members of the council, just so we'll know that we've done our best?
Absolutely.
Thank you very much. Any other new business?
I think, as best I recall, that in the email package we sent out a quick document. I don't have it in front of me on my iPads, but I do have it in paper. This is regarding that online justice training. If everyone had a chance to review it, we just wanted your input. It looks like they're wanting to be considered to offer this training for the sessions that our providers can give the officers. And so they just wanted some guidance before they officially, I guess, submitted their information.
It appears to me that this is from Craig Turner, who works for Correctional Services, which is a private probation company in Memphis. And I'm not sure if he just wants the council to put input into this product. And I'm just looking at some advice from other people on the council. I'm not sure that... I don't know at some point if he's going to market this to other people across the United States or what, but I'm concerned that we might be, and I don't know Mr. Turner, but that we might be involved in giving him an opinion on a product that said someday is going to be marketed. I'm not really sure why he's doing this.
That was my thought as well, that, you know, he's really asking us to vet this thing and critique it, and I really don't think we need to be doing that.
It sounds to me like there just might be a little conflict at some point if later on the council is asked to adopt this as something probationers or probation providers have to buy online. Any other thoughts about it?
This is David Minow. I have the same opinion. It looks like he's developing a product and wanting to market it to us is what I thought.
Yes, sir. Well, apparently he's wanting us to use it and then tell us what we think, tell him what we think. And I'm not sure that's something that the council should be doing. I mean, if anybody wanted to do it privately, I guess they could, but I'm not sure that's something we need to involve ourselves in. All right. Well, then, do you think you could contact Mr. Turner and just tell him that this is an administrative body and we don't think that we need to involve ourselves in anything except the business that comes before us by statute?
Absolutely, Judge. This is Roxanne. And I think I understand from all three points that you're in agreement that this could potentially have a conflict of interest and put the council in a bad situation. So from my perspective, we would not be endorsing, I guess, or involved in any way in this decision.
All right. Anything else any of the members wish to add about that? Any other business? Do I hear a motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn, Mr. Chairman.
Would you call a roll on that vote, please?
We need a second. I'm sorry for the motion. We need a second for the motion
to adjourn.
Second? Is there a second?
John Henson, second.
Thank you, Judge. Any discussion? Call a roll for the vote, please.
Thank you. Stanton Ford?
Aye.
Judge Lehman?
Aye.
Judge Christopher Crane?
Aye.
Judge John Henson?
Aye.
Thank you very much for your time and everything you...
Thank you, everyone, for calling in. Okay, bye.
Bye-bye.